the hill to fetch a pail of water. So they say the subsequent fall was inevitable. They never stood a chance, they were written that way. Innocent victims of their story. Like Romeo and Juliet, 'twas written in the stars before they even met. That love and fate and a touch of stupidity would rob them of their hopes of living happily. The endings are often a little bit gory. I wonder why they didn't just change their story. We're told we have to do what we're told, but surely sometimes you have to be a little bit naughty. Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, nothing will change. Even if you're little, you can do a lot. You mustn't let a little thing like little stop you. If you sit around and let them get on top, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay. As far as I can tell, her godmother was two-thirds fairy. Suddenly her lot was a lot less scary. But what if you haven't got a fairy to fix it? Sometimes you have to make a little bit of mischief. Of a bolt, there's a tiny revolt, the seeds of a war in the creak of a floorboard. A storm can begin with the flap of a wing. The tiniest might pack the mightiest grin. Every day starts with the tick of a clock. All escapes start with the click of a lock. If you're stuck in your story and want to get out, you don't have to cry, you don't have to shout. Take it.